Welcome back. Today we are diving into a project that brings together three of my favorite things, GPS, RORA, and beautiful interactable maps. Like many of you, I'm absolutely fascinated by seeing data visualized geographically. So I set out to build something that solves a common problem with a unique twist. What you're looking at is a real-time off-grid GPS tracker built on my favorite ESP32S3. Here's the breakdown. We use a high accuracy GPS module to pinpoint our location. Then we use RORA, that's the long range, low power wireless communication, to share that location with other devices. This allows us to track each other even far away from cell towers, but the real magic happens right here on the screen. I developed a custom library using LVGL to draw and render these local maps directly on the device. It's not just displaying your location, it's dynamically showing your location and the markers of all your friends or family that are out there with you. Yes, systems like Meshtastic are the backbone of modern off-grid communication. They are phenomenal. But here's the difference. My focus was on creating and open sourcing the map engine itself. This is about giving you, the builder, a reusable drop-in LVGL library for creating rich custom library map applications for hiking, geocaching, or tracking anything you need. Alright, let's jump into the build. This is the ESP32S3 device used in this project. The reason I chose this device was because of the included 3.49 inch display. Since it has a display with a resolution of 640 by 172, I thought I could implement the UI in a different way, so I chose this one. It also includes a battery, making it easy to create a portable device. However, unfortunately, it didn't include a GPS or RORA module, so I had to attach them separately. For positioning, I'm using the LC76G GPS module. This module is great because it supports both UART and I2C communication. I chose the simple UART communication for this build. It's also extremely versatile. You can easily connect this same module to Arduino, Raspberry Pi, or any other microcontroller. A reliable choice for any project that needs location data. For long-range tracking, I use Reox RORA module. It makes secure long-distance communication simple with a basic UART communication. Also, it can transmit up to 22 dBm. This power level means we are set for communication across several kilometers. Perfect for serious off-grid use. To connect everything, I simply wired both the GPS and RORA modules into unused GPIO pins on this device. A super clean install, keeping my custom wiring smooth and conflict-free. So here was a quick look at how I wired the GPS and RORA modules onto the board. With those connections made, it's time to set it up. The rest is just reassembly, so let's move on quickly and get this tracker fully assembled and ready to go. Now, a quick essential step, map data preparation. Since this tracker is for off-grid environments where there's no internet, we cannot stream maps. We have to prepare the local map tiles in advance and load them onto the SD card. But don't worry, I made a tool for this. Just grab my offline map downloader from GitHub. It makes downloading and formatting your map regions totally simple, so you're always ready, no Wi-Fi required. Once you have downloaded your regional maps using the tool, the next step is conversion. Since our LVGL map library needs to read these map tiles super fast, they need to be in a specific binary image format. But don't worry about manual conversion. I have already included a handy script in the GitHub repository that does this heavy lifting for you. You just run the script, and it quickly converts your downloaded tiles. Then it's just a simple drag and drop to copy that converted file structure onto your SD card. And just like that, the local map is ready for the ESP32S3 to read and display. Let's talk about the overall system. Every time the screen moves, it checks the GPS information for the current location. I have already shared several projects and GitHub repositories related to using local maps. As you can see, this is a tissue box. I have included a small 5-volt power bank inside the box, so this tissue box acts as a single wireless device. And also it uses the same GPS and LoRa module and are communicating via UART with the host processor. This device is ESP32P4 with a 4-inch round display, which seems suitable for developing various interesting applications. I have already introduced this device in a previous project, so please refer to that for more details. Next is the kit tracker. It's smaller, designed to be easily carried. You can find the source code in the Map Tiles project's GitHub repository. It's very straightforward. Both devices initialize the LoRa and GPS modules. They wait patiently for satellite fix, and then the map springs to life on the screen centered right on your location. I wish I could fit all those modules nearly inside the cases, but hey, that's the nature of custom hardware development. This is the exciting working prototype I want to share with you today. The screen layout is clean and simple. You have the local map as the star of the show with your location. In the background, the tracker is constantly busy. It's sending its GPS data out via LoRa and at the same time, it's waiting to receive updates from the other device. As soon as the mom device's signal comes in, both screens start displaying both device locations. They are continuously sharing GPS updates via LoRa, giving you constant real-time tracking. If you have seen my past work, you know I love using my custom map tile library. We are using that same powerful engine here, integrated with LVGR to quickly draw the maps onto the screen. Now let me walk around a bit and show you how the screen is updated. Well, actually there's nothing special. The reason I configured the mom and kid devices like this was to make it realistic. Imagine a family is at the park. Parents might be relaxing on a bench, checking their phones, while the kids are playing and quickly disappearing out of sight, maybe riding their bikes far away. That happens all the time. This device serves that, and I thought it would be fun for child to also be able to see their parents' location, adding an extra layer of peace of mind. Now, let's be honest. You could easily track things using an AirTag or similar commercial solution. They have fantastic apps and perfect tracking, and honestly, that will save you a lot of time and money. But for me, this isn't about solving the problem in the most efficient way, it's about the joy of building. This is just my hobby. I love experimenting with custom hardware and code to see what works and what's the possibility. So please don't take the practical apps too seriously. It's just a passion project. Alright, that's all for today. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next project.